I edit each of these guide videos through the night as soon as my team gets our day one clear. If you find the video useful, don't forget to drop a like and sub down below and share the video as well. Yo, what's going on, guys? It's G-Minus here. In this video, we are going over how to defeat Rulk in the Vow of the Disciple raid. To start this encounter, you're going to approach the orange force field that Rulk is emitting. And when the encounter begins, Rulk will spawn a large crystal over his head, which one player on your team should shoot. Whoever ends up getting the final blow on this will receive the Leeching Force buff. This will eventually be upgraded into the Emanating Force buff, but we are going to need three people to have this, so we are going to start by passing it around. To do this, the player with Leeching must stand on the center glyph, and by doing so, two crystals will spawn in the top right and top left of the arena. Two players who are outside of this glyph will shoot the crystals. Doing so will pass the Leeching buff to them and remove it from the player who had it originally. Now we have two players with the buff, so we are going to repeat this process one more time until we have three players with it. One of the players who just grabbed it will now go stand in the glyph plate themselves, and two players will shoot the left and right crystals again, and now at this point, three players should have the buff. Killing the glyph keeper on the left will allow anyone with the Leeching or Emanating Force to see three symbols appear. Killing the right glyph keeper will allow anyone without these buffs to see three symbols on the right side. Players should call out the left symbols, and those that can see the right symbols should pay attention for when someone mentions a symbol that both sets of players have. For example, if somebody calls out hands from the left set of symbols and I see that I also have hands as one of the right symbols, then that is the symbol that we have in common. Once you have figured out which symbol is the common one, players who do not have Leeching or Emanating should look for two deposit locations where the symbol appears. There will only ever be two locations. When they have found these locations, they should call them out, and players with the Emanating Force buff should go deposit their buff there. To actually upgrade your Leeching Force buff to Emanating Force, you need to jump in one of Rulk's solar attacks. This will reset your timer and now allow you to pass through the force field and deposit where you need to. Since we have three players with the buff, we deposit two, then we wait for the symbols to reset, and we are able to get a third deposit done. You will repeat this entire cycle twice, depositing a total of six times, and then you will move on to phase two of the boss fight. During this second phase, Rulk will do a dash attack, and afterwards you will be able to shoot his scepter. The player that shoots a scepter will get Leeching Force and cause Rulk to do a Fire Blast attack. Just like before, this player should get hit by the attack to turn Leeching Force into Emanating Force. When this is happening, everyone else on the team should be able to see a symbol appear, which they should call out to the player with Emanating Force. This symbol will correspond to one of the four corners where more deposit locations exist, and the player with the buff must deposit. Doing this will spawn a weak point on Rulk for your team to break. Do this four times over to reach damage. Here, Rulk will have a few attacks and will be damageable. Once you reach the final stand, Rulk will allow you to continue damaging him for a set amount of time before wiping your fire team. Do enough damage during this period to complete the encounter.